Hi everyone, my name is Jamad, and you guys probably know me as that Muslim Hooper or whatever nicknames everyone calls me nowadays. But but this is a get to know me video because you guys probably you've seen my videos, but you don't really know who I am type of thing. But you guys have asked me questions on Instagram, and so I'm gonna answer some of the questions. So stay tuned.
My life is super crazy. Ain't no one named my brother. Get up off them cages. You was there for me. I swear that I. If I said I need you by my side, just stay close to me. Just keep on holding me, telling me you won't ever leave. I feel like something inside me just keep controlling me. But you take all the pain. I need your energy. I'm needing you. I know you see me though. I'll be there for you. I'll be there for you. Lately I've been in my mind. I feel I'm faded. You come around, my heart is racing. I'm running so hard, I gotta make it. But you told me it's
no, but literally look how much questions. Okay, I just chose some of the questions, or like the questions that everybody asks, like most people ask. Yeah, so let's get started. I already said that, but let's actually get started. I am 21 years old. I know I look kind of younger, but yeah, pretty old. So what inspired me to play basketball was probably like watching my older brother play, and then my younger brother, who's like a year younger than me, like him play. So we used to go to the park, like my dad took us to the park like every single day, and then like seeing them get better, like I wanted to get better, and I didn't really care if like I was the only girl playing with like them and all their like friends. Yeah, my brothers, these kids play games 24/7. Literally the last 2 months, every single day they play games, and they don't stop and they keep yelling, yell, yell, yell. With their little headphones on, like, bro. Like, for me, I don't see no point of dating unless you try and get married to the person, and I'm not trying to get married right now, so I am not dating anybody anytime soon, you feel me? I'm just like, what's the point? There's no point. Listen, my skin has been on and off. In the summertime, it's amazing. Like, mashallah, I love my skin. So the winter is like where all my breakouts have. I don't even know. Like, I had clear skin until I went to Toronto, right? In December. I don't know what it was, what evil eye or anything. Boom, I get pimples all of a sudden, like out of nowhere. And I don't even get pimples like that. And like, well, like they're getting, you can see a little bit, like, but they're getting better a little bit because of my best friend here. Clindamycin and benzoyl peroxide gel, 1% and 5%. If you ever want, this is not even an ad, but if you want to get rid of your pimples, go get this. Tell the doctor to get you clindamycin and benzoyl peroxide 5% gel. The acne, they come and then they go. Like, it just takes time. But yeah, just make sure you take care of your skin. Don't just leave your skin like unmoisturized, or like if you have pimples, then like you have to like do something about it. Like, you can't just like let them sit on your face, you know? Yeah. That's my tip of the day. Okay, well, this was my favorite question. I was thinking about it all night, right? Okay, my favorite Dixie memory was, so I'm getting out of my asha, right? You know, I always get out of asha first. And then, like, this kid, this guy, I'm sorry, this is Ma'alin Yonis, right? So he goes, like, so he tells me to sit down, right? And I'm like, I'm not sitting down. Like, I want some water, right? And like, he's like, no, go sit down. You're not getting no water. I'm like, why can't I just get some water? Mind you, I was like at least 9 or 8 years old. So I'm like, I'm gonna just go get some water. I was a savage little kid. So I go get some water, and then I'm like pouring the water, right? He's just watching me. Like, he doesn't say nothing. And then he know, like, I drink the water, right? I drink the water. And then I said, ah! The water was hot. It was burning. There was no cold water. Like, the machine just put hot, and he knew, that's why he told me not to get water. And he knew, he was just staring, looking at me, right? And I'm like, burnt, my tongue is burnt by this point, right? And he's over there laughing. And well, I just ran away. I was like, that was so rude. But you know, if I was him, I would have done the same thing, to be honest. That's what I get for not listening. So I've had like one experience with Islamophobia. So not even Islamophobia, it was just like a racist comment in general. First, we're playing this team from Maine, and you know Maine is like all the way up north. She comes over to they come over to like Boston to come play us, right? And then mind you, we beat this team last year in the championship, right? So they're coming in, like we're the first one in our conference, they're the second one in our conference. Like it's a heated game, right? We thought it was gonna be a heated game, but wallahi, we won by 40. I don't know how they were the second best team in our conference, but yeah, they lost by 40. Like we busted them. And then, so I'm like we're already up by like 30 at this point, right? And then like I go take a layup, right? I didn't even care. I was like, whoever touches me, I don't really care. Well, I had this girl, she had the audacity to touch me. Audacity. I said, yo, you up by 40. We up by 40. Why you following me? You stupid. You dumb. Like, we up by 40. I'm like, yo, this girl, like, she don't even know what she's doing. Like, I'm walking back to the free throw line, right? I'm like, scoreboard, right? I was just being annoying. And then I'm at the free throw line. I'm like bouncing the ball, right? I'm about to shoot it. Kulaha, go back to your country. I said, what? What did you just say? All I said was scoreboard. This is a basketball trash talk. You feel me? Everyone says that. Kulaha, go back to your country. That's what she says. Go back to your country. At that point, I was like, yo, this girl's crazy. My favorite YouTuber has to be DDG. I think DDG is mad cool. He's funny. Definitely LeBron. I am a LeBron fan. Don't play me. 100. LeBron over Curry any day. LeBron over anybody in the NBA right now any day. So my parents judge a lot. When I'm telling you, I had mothers come up to me during Duxi. Like, I had a ma'alan who didn't even like me playing basketball. She hated me because I played basketball. And then she used to tell me all the time, like when I used to come to Duxi, like quit. I'm not quitting. You know what? People who tell me to quit, bro, like that just gives me hella energy. Like that just fires me up. Like that used to fire me up when I was younger. And I just love people saying that because, you know, I just wanted to prove them wrong and stuff like that. But yeah, they used to call my mom. They used to tell my mom, she's playing with shorts, like go get your girl. I'm like, bro, don't worry about it. I tell my mom, don't worry about it. You know? My career goals, basically people don't know this, but I am in college. I am a junior in college. I am going to graduate next year, inshallah. And I am majoring in biology because I want to go on the pre-med track and I want to be a physician assistant. And if you don't know what a physician assistant is, it's like a doctor, but they're like a doctor assistant. When I used to play basketball, I wore like my little scarf like this, you know? Like, used to always be like this. And then I wore short sleeves, and then I wore leggings over my shorts, right? And wait, let me fix this. And then that just looked weird. Like, it didn't, not for me, but like for other people. Like, you don't see people like that. Like, there's not that much girls who wear scarves and wear leggings under their shorts, right? So that was just like, the hardest thing was just sticking out. Like, when everybody saw the court, like everybody would just see me first, not even like the best player first. So like they would just see me, and I was like, I had to be like that best player, and I had to be the one who like stood out just because of what I was wearing. And like that's what gave me motivation, like till this day. Like if I wear a scarf and I play basketball, like I have to like represent for like all the Muslim girls, because like when you see a Muslim girl and like if she's nice, you're gonna be like, oh, like all the Muslim girls, like they could do this, like they're nice. So yeah, that's exactly like what gave me motivation to like work hard and actually like be nice. My birthday is February 23rd, and my celebrity crush, I think I'm gonna say Polo G. Polo G is my celebrity crush. My advice to someone who wants to play basketball is that make sure you work hard every day. Do not give up. Even if like you feel like you're not the best, like you could easily turn out. Like look at like Michael Jordan, for example. He got kicked off of his 10th grade varsity team. Like he didn't even play varsity in 10th grade. Even if you're like not the best one on your team, just make sure that you work hard. You're the hardest worker there. Like that's what people really look at. Like if you work hard, that means you'll get better. And yeah. Just keep working hard, like do not take a day off, like don't be lazy, you gotta be consistent. Yeah, so it is officially the end of the video, and I just want to thank you guys for tuning in. Thank you guys for listening to all the questions that I've answered, and yeah, just make sure you like, subscribe, and comment down below any videos, anything you want me to talk about, any challenge you want me to do, any basketball challenges you want me to do, I got you. But yeah, just make sure you like, subscribe, and comment, okay? Thanks, guys.